Hi folks, you've made a part and it looks beautiful, like this one here, but the most important thing is, are the dimensions correct? Otherwise this is just scrap. And for that you might want to grab your digital caliper here. And in this video I want to show you how I get good measurements with this caliper. There are basically three dimensions you can measure with a caliper. That is the outside measurement, inside measurement, and the depth, like that or like that. I will show you this in detail now. First, we want to start with the outside dimension. Before you start measuring something, always make sure the measuring surfaces are clean and your caliper goes to zero when you close it. Also, the surface you want to measure has to be clean. And before I start something to measure, I always think about what errors can I make. For example, here for the outside dimension, I cannot measure something that is smaller than the actual dimension. Of course, I have to always apply the same pressure on my thumb here. That's the basic. And the second thing I ask myself is what alignment is critical to get good measurements. For example, here for the outside dimension, I cannot get a smaller value than the actual value. So when I get different readings because I cannot align the caliper correctly, or I have a strange position where I have to measure, the lowest value I can read is mostly like the right value or near to the right value. Here for the outside dimension, there are mostly 1 degree of freedom that is really critical. There's also this degree of freedom, but that will align automatically because of the normally, depending on the shape of it, thing you want to measure. But there's also this degree of freedom you have to align correctly. And if this is not aligned correctly, like that, you get a bigger measurement. But it will also align quite automatically when you just put in the piece you want to measure, wiggle around a little bit, and here you can see I get the right measurement. This is 20 millimeters, and I can read 20 millimeters. I also try to use the inner area of the measuring surface here and not the tip, because here you are not so far away from the linear scale on the caliper here, and that will make things more accurate. And also it's not so sensitive to the pressure you apply with your thumb here. For example, when I try to measure this 20 millimeters with the tip here, I can also get the 20 millimeters, of course, but when I increase the pressure here, I can easily go under. And when I do the same thing on the back here and apply the same pressure, you can see I can also get under measurement, but not as much as at the front here. And also some other dimensions like this here, 50 millimeters, easily to measure, and here a really big one, 100 millimeters. It's a little bit under, but I think that's the accuracy of the caliper here. So yeah, it's pretty consistent, 99.99 or 100. Let's continue with the measuring of an inside dimension here. That's a little bit more difficult than the outside dimension because you have one more degree of freedom and all of them matter for the measured value. Here for the inside dimension, I cannot measure a bigger value again, and it will mostly like smaller than the actual diameter. And for that, you will know that the biggest value will mostly like the correct one. And here in the inside dimension, you have this alignment that has to be correct, and this alignment that has to be correct, and you also have to center the measuring surfaces so you can measure the right diameter here. Let's try this on this part here. And you can see 27.89, that's not the correct dimension, 27.99. When you tilt it like that, it will get smaller. When you go off center, it will get smaller, of course. And also when you tilt it like that, it will also get smaller. So I have the reading is now, you can see it's not that easy, because when you wiggle around, the value jumps around. Now I have 28. And be careful not to apply too much pressure here, because when you wiggle around, you might increase the pressure automatically. Yeah, okay, I have mostly 27.99, but it sometimes jumps to 28 millimeters. And this ring here has 28.001 millimeters. So the measurement with the caliper is quite accurate. I can also try this bigger ring here now. I have the feeling the bigger the diameter is, the more difficult it gets, but also very small diameters are difficult. So this one was a quite easy diameter. And here we have 61.89. Now, when I wiggle around a little bit, 61.99 was the highest value I was able to see. And that's also the correct one, because this one has 61.996 millimeters. So you can see, not that easy to measure an inside diameter, but also possible to measure it quite precisely with this caliper here. Of course, you cannot measure the roundness of this circle here, but that's another point. There are specialized measurement instruments to measure this circle correctly. So this is just for a quick check. The last thing you can measure with a caliper is the depth or the height of a step or something like that. And for that, you have two options. One is this step here on the back of the caliper. When you close it, it is a flush surface, and when you open it, you can measure the depth. And you also have this rod that comes out on the bottom of the caliper. That's more for a small bore or something like that to measure the depth of that. Let's see what errors we can make here. The measurement will always be bigger or equal the right measurement, so the smallest value will be mostly like the correct one. And alignment wise, you have to align it correctly in this direction and tilt it correctly in this direction. So you only have 2 degrees of freedom compared to the inner dimension. So it should be a little bit easier to measure the right value. But in my experience, when you want to measure the depth, it's always in some awkward position, and then it's more difficult because you can't reach the area where we want to measure good. And to measure with this step here, I always align the stationary part then, that's this part, with the upper shoulder, and then I lower the rod until it touches the bottom. And here you can see I can get the 50 millimeters, which is the size of the sketch block here. And that's relatively easy to get a good measurement when you can use this surface here. But sometimes you don't have enough space and you have to use this one here. There you have the problem. Let's put this upright, because otherwise it won't really work. You can't measure it really good like this, because you don't have any surface here to rest the caliper on. And so you have to turn it around, and in most situations you won't see the reading while you measure. That makes it a little bit more difficult. And then you have to align the caliper on the top here, lower the rod down until it touches the bottom, try to get the alignment correctly, and also try not to bump the measurement when you remove the caliper. And here I have 49.99, so that was really lucky with the measurement. but it's really not that easy to measure the depth. That's all for this video now. I tried to keep this as short as possible and also put in as much information as possible. It's a little bit of an experiment to do such a video for me. So if you liked it, please leave a thumb up, and you can also leave a comment with some more tips if you have some. And don't forget to subscribe if you like my channel, turn on the notification bell, and see you next time.